This is our first question. A B is a chord of a circle of radius 14 centimeter. A circle is having radius 14 centimeter. A circle is having radius 14 centimeter. A B is a chord of a circle of radius 14. Okay. The chord subtends a right angle at the center of the circle. Find the area of the minor segment. Okay. So what I will do, I am taking a circle and I have a chord AB. This is center of the circle. The chord subtends a right angle at the center. If you join these two ends, here it is giving a right angle. What is the area of the minor segment? This is the segment. Okay. And we already know. I didn't take attendance, sir. Just wait. In the theory, we already discussed area of the segment means, this is the formula. Area of the segment is area of the sector minus area of the triangle. Area of the sector is theta by 360 into pi r square minus half into r square sine theta. This is the area of segment. Just we will substitute, simplify. Coming to the solution, I am calculating area of segment, which is nothing but area of sector minus area of triangle. Area of sector is theta by 360 into pi r square. Area of the triangle is half r square sine theta. So we have the angle given 90 degrees. And angle, I can write 90 means pi by 2. Okay. Divided by 360. Okay. Or you write 90, then we will cancel off with 360. That doesn't make much difference. R value is 14. This is 14 square. Half, again 14 square. Sine 90 degrees. Numerator is 90 degrees. 94s are 360. So it becomes 1 by 4 into pi into 14 into 14 minus half into 14 into 14. Okay, sine 90 value is 1. So 14 square already we have in common. What is the other things left out? Half also we have common. And then pi by 2 is left out minus 1. Okay, pi means 3.14. We already know 3.514. Okay, so pi by 2 means you divide this 3.14 by 2, which is 1.57. And then minus 1. You have pi by 2 minus 1. If you subtract 1, it becomes 0.57. So pi by 2 minus 1 means 0.57. Now you multiply this. Here we have 14 into, if you cancel this 2, we have 7. Then we have 0.57. Okay. You just multiply all these things. That is our final answer. 55.86 centimeter square. We are finding the area and all the values given are centimeter. Whatever we have, the dimensions given, it is in centimeter. So the final answer also centimeter. 55.86. Centimeter square. Okay, this is about the area of segment. I'm going to next problem. ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. And AB is the diameter of the circle. AB is the diameter of the circle. So I have taken it. This is AB, diameter of the circle. Then what is the value of ADC? This angle we have to find out. This angle we have to find out. Okay. So cyclic quadrilateral, we have seen the theory. Cyclic quadrilateral, we have seen the theory, which means the four sides, the diagram which has four sides present inside a circle. Present inside a circle. We have come across the terminology cyclic quadrilateral. In that case, opposite angles in a cyclic quadrilateral, sum is equal to 180 degrees. Opposite angle, sum equal to 180 degrees. So what we have? So D and B together, angle D and B together, it is 180 degrees. Already A is half cut here with this line. Okay, A angle is already cut. If you have the full angle of A, if you have the full angle of C, that sum is also 180 degrees. That is the meaning of opposite angles in a cyclic quadrilateral, 180. And then we also have another point. Angle in a semicircle is a right angle. Angle in a semicircle is a right angle. So where we can apply this, you check this diagram. You check the diagram. Angle in a semicircle is 90 degrees. Okay. So here if you see, AB is cutting the circle. Full circle is cut by AB. And AB is called diameter. So we have a semicircle on the upper side of AB and the lower side of AB also we have with respect to AB. On the upper side one semicircle, on the lower side you have another semicircle. Okay. And angle made by semicircle is 90 degrees. Angle made by semicircle is 90 degrees. If you take AC, BC are the lines drawn with respect to diameter. With respect to diameter, you are forming an angle here. This angle equal to 90 degrees. This angle equal to 90 degrees. Okay. So these two lines are formed. This is the angle formed by semicircle. Angle formed by semicircle. Where is the angle? Angle C. Angle C is formed by semicircle. So here angle C is nothing but right angle 90 degrees. I showed you the theoretical point. So based on that, we can have 90 degrees for angle C. Now you take the triangle. I'm coming to the actual solution. Whatever discussed till now is just for the background understanding, rough. And now I'm going with the actual solution. So ACB is a triangle where sum of the angles will be equal to 180 degrees. Sum of angles in a triangle equal to 180 degrees. Already we know angle A. Now we have calculated angle C. We are left out with the angle B calculation. So we have to find out angle B. A is 48, C is 90. Now angle B we are yet to find. This is 180 degrees. So if you subtract, what happens? 90 minus 48. So angle B value equal to 42 degrees. 42 degrees. Okay, this is step one. I am finding angle B. This is step one. Now coming to step two, what I will do? Opposite sides, opposite angles in a cyclic quadrilateral equal to 180 degrees. Okay. Opposite angles in cyclic quadrilateral. I showed you the theoretical point also. Quadrilateral, okay, which is present inside the circle equal to 180 degrees. So in that case, angle D plus angle B, which will be equal to sum of 180 degrees. Sum will make 180 degrees. Now we are supposed to find D, that is our actual question. B is 42 and this is 180. Now from here angle D is nothing but 138 is okay. Okay, 138 degrees. 138 degrees. This is the angle D. Okay, this is about the second problem.